Hello friends, myself Mahipal Parmar, and let we are going to continue our derivation from the last step. So let our last step, that is v2 is equal to under root 2000 h1 minus h2 plus v1 square, that is velocity is in meter per second. Let denote h1 minus h2 is equal to hd, where hd is the enthalpy drop or a heat drop during the expansion of steam in a nozzle. So put this hd in the place of h1 minus h2 in the equation 3, we will get the v2 is equal to under root 2000 hd plus v1 square. This is the given equation number 4. Now let's consider the entrance or inlet velocity. We can also set the velocity of our approach v1 is negligible as compared to the exit or a final velocity v2, because at the exit of the nozzle we will get the maximum or highest velocity of a steam compared to the inlet section. So v2 is very much higher than the v1, so we can easily neglect this term v1 from the equation 3 and 4, and this equation 3 and 4 can be rewritten as v2 is equal to under root 2000 h1 minus h2. Now to find out the square root of 2000, we will get the 44.72, and we can rewrite this equation as a 44.72 under root h1 minus h2. Now you can also rewrite this h1 minus h2 as a hd. Here I have put one note that in actual practice there is always some friction between the steam and nozzle surface. That means when the steam is flowing through the nozzle, there is some friction which is developed between the nozzle surface and steam. It ultimately develops the heat. Yeah, that means energy is lost and it converted into the heat. And again, this heat which is produced due to the friction is add into the steam, and it increases your weight condition of a steam. This reduces the heat drop by the 10 to 15%, and thus the exit velocity of a steam is also reduced, as we can discuss. Therefore we have to consider the nozzle efficiency during the calculation of a exit velocity or a mass flow rate. So v2 is equal to 44.72 under root eta n, that is n hd, where eta n is the nozzle efficiency. So let's understand what is nozzle efficiency and how can we derive the nozzle efficiency. Here we have one diagram that is on the h against s, that is enthalpy versus entropy diagram. Here we can see that is point 1, that is enthalpy, our enthalpy at inlet, and h2s, that is enthalpy at the outlet or at a exit side. In we have two processes, that is 1 to 2s, it shows the isentropic process, or 1 to 2a, it represents the actual process. So nozzle efficiency is defined as the ratio of the actual enthalpy drop to the isentropic enthalpy drop. This diagram is also called as the Mollier diagram, friends. Okay, Mollier diagram, in which we are representing the enthalpy and entropy, enthalpy on the y-axis and entropy on the x-axis. Here you can see, due to the friction, our enthalpy drop is going to reduce from the 2h2s to the h2a, and due to that our velocity is also going to reduce from the v2s square divided by 2 to the v2s square divided by 2. So ultimately, due to the friction, we will get the less velocity at the exit compared to the standard condition, or due to the isentropic expansion. So mathematically we can rewrite this nozzle efficiency as h1 minus h2a divided by h1 minus h2s, that is actual enthalpy drop divided by the isentropic enthalpy drop. So eta n, we can also rewrite this eta n as a useful heat drop divided by the isentropic heat drop. Here I have also put one note, that is nozzle efficiency generally varies from the 0.85 to the 0.95%. I hope, friends, you will understand how to derive the exit velocity of a steam from the nozzle and nozzle efficiency. Thank you so much, friend, and stay tuned. In further lecture, we are going to study the maximum mass flow rate of a steam through the nozzle, and what is the condition for the maximum mass flow rate for the steam.